coalition of more than 230 organizations, over 1,000 businesses, and hundreds of faith-based leaders calling for a statewide ban on hydraulic fracturing in New York State. We're also here today to demand that Governor Cuomo and the Department of Environmental Conservation withdraw the proposed liquefied natural gas regulation. These regulations are currently designed to allow for the unfettered transport and export to foreign markets of gas that is fracked in New York.
DEC only offered up one recent study to support its proposal, but that report was from a blatantly conflicted consulting firm. The firm, in fact, holds patents and is marketing a process for fracking and also for mobile LNG production facilities, which, by the way, appear to be exempted from direct regulation by DEC.
According from DEC's impact statement, the type of facilities that we could see here in New York State if these rules are adopted include not just gas stations. They also include LNG export and import terminals, plants that produce, store, and vaporize LNG, regional LNG production facilities, big ones, LNG facilities that are attached to gas pipelines, LNG facilities at gas wells. Yes, gas wells, you know, fracking. The fact is that DEC's regs support a virtual smorgasbord of fracking and natural gas infrastructure. The rules contain no limit whatsoever on how big these facilities could become.
LNG is not safe. It's inherently dangerous, and far from being environmentally beneficial, LNG is a destroyer of climate stability. It contributes to air and water pollution. It undercuts technologies like wind, water, and solar power that are truly beneficial. LNG is methane that is super cool to minus 259 degrees, and that refrigeration alone requires massive amounts of carbon-based energy. And in addition to stay cold, a tank of LNG must regularly vent methane gas to add evaporative cooling to the refrigeration process. LNG tanks leak methane by design. They have to.
They're talking about building mobile facilities to liquefy natural gas on the site at the well pad. You know what? If we allow these facilities in New York under these current regulations across the southern tier of New York, we would have truck after truck after truck coming over the Pennsylvania border delivering natural gas and ruining the communities of Pennsylvania. That would be providing the market for the destruction of northern Pennsylvania. And that's before we get a ban on fracking in New York.
Hey, hey! Whoa, whoa! LNG has got to go! Hey, hey! Whoa, whoa!
I'm here to tell you that your proposed draft regulations contain no science, none. And this fact has not gone unnoticed by New York State's scientific and public health community. Traditionally, a public hearing during the rulemaking process is a chance to bring additional data forward that might be relevant to the law. But you, DEC, have given us a different task during this comment period. Your failure to provide an impartial state of the science summary of the environmental and health risks of lifting New York State's 40-year moratorium on liquefied natural gas facilities means that we must bring all the data to you. That work is underway, and what it shows is that DEC's central claim to the public about the regs and in the regs themselves is that the LNG is safe and provides environmental benefits to New York State is nothing more than an industry talking point. The source of this statement is what you call the 2011 NYSERDA study that turns out to be a document authored by Expansion Energy, a company deeply invested in LNG technology and fracking, and that is shameful. Here is what the science actually says. LNG has a life cycle carbon footprint roughly the size of coal. That's because immense amounts of carbon-based energy must be used just to liquefy it, via extreme refrigeration, and because LNG tanks must leak methane by design in order to stay cool. Your regs and the public statements you make about the regs emphasize that LNG's air emissions upon combustion are cleaner than other fossil fuels. That is a misleading sleight of hand statement. Even my 12-year-old understands what a life cycle analysis is. Tailpipes are only part of the story. Over its life cycle, LNG is not a low emission fuel. Because of the energy-intensive cryogenics, because of methane venting, because flaring is required during regasification, LNG contributes both to smog and climate change, It releases just as much of toxic emissions in places other than the freeway, like our communities. Thus, these regs are not only unsubstantiated by peer-reviewed science, the claims they make are misleading and deceptive, and New York State's public health community will be making this point forcefully and in detail in our written comments. And so will members of the general public. Many of the people here contribute to an online program called 30 Days of Fracking Regs. How many of you are writing those 30 days? So DEC, you're gonna get thousands of comments by your deadline. I hope you're ready for that. Concerned Health Professionals of New York joins together with New Yorkers Against Fracking in calling for withdrawing these regs and starting over. Thank you.
All this speaks to me for the need for the DEC to take a comprehensive look. A full environmental impact statement needs to be done on the LNG facilities, not in isolation, but connected to fracked gas. I'll say that again. This is connected to fracked gas.
It has everything to do with fracking. We're enabling states to produce what is already a glut of natural gas to be exported. I travel all over the world. I was in Turkey recently when President Obama made an agreement to import natural gas to Turkey. I don't see how with the natural gas we already have fracked in other states, where reparations will be necessary, where money will have to go to the reparations for those people in those states that have gag orders now so that we can't hear about it. Why then are we building export facilities to send our gas to countries that have banned fracking because it's unsafe? Thanks very much.